here.
Yes, sir.
To the Black Trans History panel.
I wanted to do this because several years ago, Michelle W. meets her name, if you all know her. She organized a Black Trans History event. Went to it every year. It was the most dopest event I've been to, very affirming. And I thought it was important because oftentimes we don't get to celebrate ourselves, right? As Black people, as Black trans people, we often don't get to celebrate ourselves. I had people confused about the purpose of this event. And I'm like, celebration? They're like, what do you mean? That was confusing to them. Celebrate yourself. You know, so if you don't know, it's a celebration of Black trans individuals. So if you are Black and trans, please give yourself a round of applause.
I got a big mouth. I was, before I do answer any questions, I just want to say thank you so much. This has touched my heart so much. There's someone, and I wish that Lonnie Grant was here, because we were sitting at 1201 Locust Street trying to figure out what to do to make Black information enough to affirm Blackness within an organization that was galette. And Lonnie Gray and I sat there and I said, well, it's February, why not have a Black History Month award celebration? And I wish he was here for my, I see people, I see so many people here who have accepted, who I had the pleasure of giving awards to. There's two right there. Here's one right here. Here's one right here. You know, I see many people that I have had the pleasure of giving awards to. When I thought of this, it was because we hear when we do something wrong, but we never hear when you do something right. You never hear when you do something right. And that was my thought of giving it that, making people feel like they're worth something. You know? And I don't mean to get emotional, but I'm so honored. I really am. I'm so honored that someone told me I had a good idea.
You did.
This young lady right here is doing, the work that this young lady right here is doing, the work that Deja's doing, you know, it lets me know that it wasn't in vain, that it's not in vain. Thank you so much. I mean, that.
You know, a little bit of the progress you've seen since coming out, when we first came out as trans, you know, was kind of some of the differences.
Well, this is a difference right here. This is a big difference. Because it was because we're in Greenway, but we wouldn't even have had a Greenway Center back when I'll be 60 this year in Denver.
Yeah!
Wouldn't have even had a Wimbley Center. You wouldn't even have that a Trans Black History or Black History Month celebration. You know? I mean, we've come a long way, but, and I don't hope I don't step on anyone's toes, I'm gonna say that. But with that asshole Trump in my environment, I don't know.
Right. Amen.
I don't know, man. Don't
wait for me. Who cares? Who cares? Non-factor. Non-motherfucker factor.
Let's keep it real.
Okay. Got me high.
You've got places like the attic. You got places like the attic. You got places like Colors. You got places like Galilee.
I remember me, Rick, Amina. I remember Amina. I remember Amina. When Jackie took me to my first, the first trans health conference. The first trans health conference over on Arch Street.
Yeah.
The media, yeah, over on Arch Street. She was so skinny. But we've come a long way. But we still have a struggle against it. Because you have people in office that's taking away human rights.
Right.
You know, and it's not right. It's not right. But I'm glad that I'm sitting. I have hope because I'm sitting next to a young lady that I know is going to do the best damn job she can.
So, Michelle, you know, recently, everybody was once like in New Orleans. She's the fifth trans woman this year. What advice do you have for trans women of color and fearful right now?
You know, like I said, I'm 60 years old, but I still got the feeling for the playground. And so I go online and I meet people. But I've had guns pulled on me in my apartment. I've had a guy, Joe Blunt, knock me on my bed and raise his foot over my face and he's gonna slap me in my face. The best thing that I can say, but my husband is in prison. I'm getting ready to leave because I'm done waiting. The best thing I can say is that when I invite someone to my house, if they don't have a picture online or anything, I don't bring them over. If they don't have a picture, if they do have a picture, I call. Me and her have a code.
Yeah.
We have a code, you know. This is my best friend, Tini Kawata. But we have a code. You know, I mean, it, you have to protect yourself. You know? I mean, it's nothing wrong with if you two are friends and you're going to call someone over, call her and give it up. I don't know if you love her or not.
Well, but everyone wants to know.
but it's nothing wrong with letting someone know who's coming to you.
Right.
There's nothing wrong with letting someone know who's coming to you. With Trump in office, people are starting to feel like they have a right to be president. They have a right to get civil and want to be. You know, and that's, but that's not right. That's not right. I don't have a right to hurt anyone's feelings. I don't have that right to hurt anybody's feelings anywhere or anywhere else. That's what I've always tried to live by. I don't have a right to hurt anybody's feelings because I know how it feels when I've been, my feelings have been hurt.
Right.
You
know? Hey. First question, I would like to know if you can share with everybody. Why is it important for you to share your story?
Why is it important?
Because
I have a story.
Yes, I know you, and I do also do outreach education at the Ed Youth Center. So I'm 20 years old. It's important for youth to share their stories because we all have multiple intersection identities. So I don't just experience anti-black racism because I'm biracial. I just don't experience sexism because I'm a woman. I don't just experience transphobia or cissexism because I'm trans. But all of these things cannot be considered independently, that they all overlap over each other. So we all have unique experiences, walking down the street, going to the store, going into systems that are supposed to care and support. support us. So that's why it's important for youth specifically, and also adultism for youth, that they experience, that youth can voice their opinions or say who they are, because adults won't believe them, or people older. But yeah, specifically in my story, I have experienced a lot of adultism and transphobia around myself, going to an all-boys high school, coming out as trans in my 12th grade year in an all-boys high school.
I'm finding so many different mentalities. It seems challenging. I don't say hard, because the only thing hard is behind the creek that we walk on. Everything else is a challenge.